Joining us now via phone is the CEO of Jordan Winery, John Jordan. First off, to the most important question here, John, how are your employees doing and how are you doing?
Well, fortunately, all of our employees are safe. On the sad side, we've got more than a half a dozen and counting that have lost their homes and lost everything they owned. And most of them, God bless them, came into work today.
You're kidding. That is incredible.
No, it's just amazing.
Just amazing. Six employees losing their homes and still showing up. John, what about your vineyards? Can you give us a condition? Have you gone and checked on them?
Well, yes, I have. You can't not here in the wine country. Just to paint a picture for the viewers, I'm standing outside. You can't look up and see the sky. It's this brownish gray. There's no sun coming through. It's as if it looks like it's about to rain. And it's been that way for about 36 hours. The smell of the ashes gets into everything. Yesterday, it snowed ashes all over my house.
You're in the heart of wine country, and as you look at the impact of your vineyards, let's just say they're not torched. Will that smoke, will that ash ruin or somehow affect negatively the next year's crop?
Well, for sure it's not going to help, right? But fortunately, Cabernet and Merlot grapes tend to be thicker-skinned grapes than, say, Chardonnay, for example, a lot of your white varietals. And there are certain processes when they come into the cellar to rid them of some of the smoke taint. But it remains to be seen exactly how much flavor degradation there will be.
How close is the fire to you, John? And I ask that because thousands of people have been ordered to evacuate. Have you been swept up in that perimeter?
No, but this is a highly, highly fluid situation, Liz. Right now, CAL FIRE is reporting 0% containment on the big fire, which is the Tubbs fire that's caused all the damage. And so a big pickup in winds can cause these fires to go in any different direction. And right now, I'm outside of the evacuation zone, but not too far outside, so it wouldn't take much for it to come this way.
Well, I'm sure you appreciate that President Trump has very quickly declared this a disaster situation, and they're bringing in firefighters from as far away as Nevada to help out. But what does this do to the economy of California? Wine is a huge export and a huge boon for California.
Well, just for Sonoma and Napa counties, for instance, you know, as you know, the wine industry is a multi-billion, about $4.5 billion a year here. But what people don't realize is that Sonoma County and Napa County are wonderful places to visit. And tourism, food and wine tourism, has been a huge, growing part of our economy. And we've never had anything like this happen. But just so you know, Sonoma County is still open. We need your business. The restaurants, all the small businesses would love to have people come. It's still a beautiful place, and the smoke will blow away, so come see us.
This brings to mind, and again, we know the loss of life is just awful. 15 now confirmed dead from this fire, but as a business network, we have to ask, will this mean that California wines will jump up in price?
Unknown, Liz. That could certainly happen. As you pointed out at the beginning of the segment, you know, a lot of the wine was already in prior to this, and a lot of it may be treatable in the cellar when it comes in. Well, that's a big unknown, but it certainly raises the possibility of upward pressure on wines. Now, your viewers may not know that wine, it's harvested 1 year, but it doesn't come to market until years hence.
Right.
Especially red wines. I mean, our Jordan wine Cabernet, fortunately our Cabernet grapes are in, but it takes 4 years from harvest to release. So any price effects won't be felt initially from damage to this vintage for a few years.
We just saw a Hilton hotel just burned to the ground. Horrible. Cars torched, homes destroyed. John, hang in there, and we wish you and your employees much safety. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Liz.